Welcome, sports fans. Thanks for joining us. With Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. And it's time for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Our starting lineups will look at the matchups here and who we'll see for our starting five for both teams. First, for the Pacers, Collison is out there with Oladipo. They've got Turner. A big game for this young man making his NBA debut. And it's Young in at the four spot. And looking at the Cavaliers, Derrick Rose is out there with J.R. Smith. They've got Tristan Thompson, a very solid big man who'll be making every effort to control the glass and make some big plays under the rim. Then it's LeBron James, and it's Love in at the four slot.
Well, I tell you what, the Pacers did a lot of good things last year. Defended well, protected the rim and their home court. And really, the one area for improvement is probably the road record. They could get better in that area.
So Cleveland will get the first possession. The drive by LeBron. Gets the bucket.
Well, his body control is what I notice. I think that jumps off the page when you watch him play. Even with a defender draped all over, he's able to find a way to get to the rim and get the shot to go in.
And there's something else on his resume that can't be overlooked. Just how many times he's taken over at the end of close games and carried his team to the win.
Collison kicks to Oladipo. No good off the front iron. Well, Clark, as you said, the Pacers didn't play as well as they had hoped to on the road for a team that won the division. They were 19-21 away from Indianapolis, and Steve, not the kind of record they wanted to end with.
No, but if you're around 500 and then you can control your home court, you're going to have a good season. And that's exactly what Indiana did. They ended up with the third seed in the East, and all in all, a terrific year.
Cleveland shooting their first free throw of the game.
Well, they were 75% free throw shooting a season ago.
And, you know, there was plenty of blame to go around for that. I mean, it wasn't just one or two guys. I mean, for the most part, the entire team struggled. I tell you what, the Cavs can certainly attest to how strong the Central Division was last year. It was a big problem for the Cavs finding wins against the rest of their division mates, and they ended up last in the Central Division standing.
Off target with the open look.
I thought he'd make that one. I mean, that's his range, and the defense nowhere to be seen.
Love with the screen on Collison. Smith kicks to Love. Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession. And for the Cavs, nobody expected them to win the Central by any means. But, Steve, their fans were hoping they could avoid another finish at the bottom of the heap and a division record of 3-13.
Well, that's three straight finishes at the bottom of the Central Division for them. But look, this is a tough group of teams with Indiana and Chicago, of course, at the top. But, you know, Cleveland is a young team. They're going up against some veteran squads. They should be better as this season goes on and as their young players continue to improve.
Here is Love. After Darren Collison's bucket, that's a shot he doesn't shoot very often. Rose has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Here's Collison. 19 seconds left here in the opening quarter. And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's his first foul. Back. 15 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Brooks kicks to Robinson. Robinson left side. Back to Brooks. 1 second left. That misses. Would have counted had it gone in. And so the first quarter is in the books. Cleveland ahead. They lead by 6. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. And now the second quarter, just getting set to start.
You know, in order to win your division, you have to be able to win games against the rest of your conference, and that's exactly what Indiana did last season. A tough team in a tough division, and they gave no ground to other teams in the East.
Brooks gets the screen from Jefferson. Stevenson dishes to Brooks, and the three ball is good. Brooks has got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for Indiana. On defense, the Pacers. It's a three-point game. And the Pacers, as you mentioned, Clark, very solid against the other teams in the East as they would cruise to a 31-20 record against the rest of the conference.
And really, that's because this team is built to handle anything that's thrown at them. Kevin, it's a big, strong, kind of old-school team. They'll pound you inside, they rebound, they protect the paint. There aren't a lot of matchups that seem to bother this team.
They double him with LeBron. Six on the shot clock. On the wing, and that one off the back of the rim and in. Brooks has got five here in the second quarter with a little over a minute gone. Love outside. And he jams it with authority.
You know, nobody responds to end-of-game pressure like this guy. That's what comes to mind immediately for me. He's hit some monumental shots in his career. Some guys just embrace the moment at the end of the game. That's him.
And another thing about his game that's really noticeable is how well he handles defensive pressure when he's getting the shot off. He's a very composed shooter.
Here is Stevenson following the score by Cleaver. Jefferson, a screen on LeBron. That evens the score.
He had a whole lot of space to get that shot off.
Yeah, I don't think the defender did a good job there of getting over the top of the screen.
Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half played. This game open.
Yeah, I like that. I mean, some coaches might want to see just a sure-handed lay-in, but I say put as much as you can on the finish and get your teammates going.
And it's the Pacers with the ball, following the score by Cleaver, and the foul on Derrick Rose. That's foul number two for him. Here's Young. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. 1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. Lee Baz was put in just the right spot.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
On its way from Rook, and it's in. Oh, wow, he nails the buzzer beater.
Pretty shot without a second to spare.
That can be so demoralizing for the team that gives up a shot like that to close out a quarter.
Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Cavaliers lead by two. And coming up after the break, it'll be Damon Bruce breaking down all the highlights from the first half of play.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
And now it's time to break down the first half for you here on this Wednesday edition of 2K at the Half. At Quicken Loans Arena, the Cavaliers in a close one against Indiana. Through two quarters, their offense has been simply unstoppable. Bucket after bucket after bucket after bucket after bucket, you get it. LeBron playing well in the first half. They're also seeing Derrick Rose put up some solid numbers in this one. Good overall, also, though, for the Pacers. Excellent bench production, the second string coming in, knocking down the shots. Aaron Brooks leading the team in scoring. They've also seen the numbers out of Thaddeus Young in the first half. Now time to get you back out to the game in Cleveland. Second half, coming right up.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
He has that slasher mentality, guys. And we saw all the evidence of that in the first half as he continually got to the rim and scored.
Yeah, he had the jetpack on today, Steve, blowing by the defender no matter who they put on.
Here's Bogdanovich. Just five on the clock. Here's Collison, and the rejection by Smith. Rose against Young. He dishes it to Lodge. It's stolen by Oladipo. Indiana trailing here. Collison with it, and Rose picks him up defensively. Collison off the pick from Turner. Oladipo, the pass to Bogdanovich. and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Well, you got to be so careful with him defensively because he has the ability to get hot at a moment's notice. And if that happens at the wrong time, we're in some big trouble.
And you've really got to also admire his steadiness. I mean, no matter what the situation is, he's not going to change his game and risk a drop-off. Very consistent in his approach and production.
Al Jefferson's checked in for Indiana.
There's not a lot you can say that hasn't been said before about his skill at the charity stripe.
LeBron kicks to Thompson. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip. They've got a battle inside.
Well, this game has been tough, Clark. I mean, they're getting after it. And I think they're starting to run a little bit low on energy, possibly.
Here's Jefferson. Tristan Thompson picking up that last bucket. They can go two for one.
Yeah, they need to play it smart. Make sure you get a good shot first, and then maybe a second possession.
James, smooth as silk on the finger roll. LeBron's got 9 points.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
Man, it's not necessarily strategic, Clark. It's just a matter of playing with more heart. Got to play hard, guys.
Knocked loose and stolen by LeBron. For the finish. And he cranked off the fast break with a monster slam.
Well, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Collison off the pick from Bogdanović. Collison kicks to Oladipo. Soft touch off the glass. Oladipo's got his first bucket in this one.
I'll tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Here's Rose. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
You know, there's no fear out of him, guys. I mean, going straight to the hoop against a much bigger defender, he's got a lot of heart.
The Cavaliers have gone 1 for 1, making their previous attempt at the line. The free throw drops for Rose. And we've watched 3 so far in this one. Cavaliers ahead, up 5. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for the Cavaliers?
Boy, guys, I really like how they've driven the ball to the basket in this game. I mean, they've been very aggressive with it.
And they're getting the ball inside, which is what I like. High percentage shots down on the block and in the paint area.
Here's Oladipo, following the basket by LeBron James. Collison, good.
Beautiful finger roll to cap that drive off. He knows how to finish with some flair and flavor, guys.
The Cavaliers leading by 5. LeBron drives in, and the shot is good. LeBron's got 4 points now in the quarter.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
And Oladipo gets to Turner. He passes to Bogdanović. Oladipo. Offline with his 3. 1:19 left in the game. Rob outside. All sorts of time. After the shoulder that time, all met. And it's a 9-point Cavalier lead.
They have a hotter hand in the first half so far, no question.
Yeah, it's because of all the high percentage shots they've been working for and getting.
Now here's Collison. Kicks it to Oladipo. LeBron grabs the miss. For Cleveland, they've gotten all 3 of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. Smith. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. There's the dish to Oladipo. Buries the long-range jumper.
That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there. Boy, extremely opportunistic defense leading to those points there.
That dunk clock coming within seconds of the steal.
Love the way they convert from defense to offense.
But that's what happens when you get all five guys on a string defensively ready to react and make a play.
Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pacers will take it.
Boy, that's embarrassing, guys. He's going to have a hard time living that one down later when they watch it on tape.
.32 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's the feed to Collison. He kicks to Oladipo. Releases. The rebound by Kevin Love.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
That's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Yep, you got to extend the game here. Try to keep that clock from moving.
And he commits the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a five-point game.
And I'll tell you what, those two free throws give them some much-needed breathing room, guys. It's now a two-possession game.
.15 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. A three ball. And a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Smith drives in.
Well, that's a wrap, fellas. No way you come back in this one.
Not anymore. Any chance of that happening went out the window a while ago.
Timeout called the Pacers. They trail by 7. Just 4 seconds left in the fourth. Guys, what do you think?
Well, never say never, I guess. They just have no quit in them.
I think you have to respect that attitude and approach. I know most teams would have called it a game already.
Looked to me like the defender didn't get squared up and get his feet set.
Good work by the officials. A nice call. That play can be tough to judge sometimes.
He drops the first one, and that trims the lead to 6. And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there. And so it's Cleveland winning this one. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan thanking Warts. And now, Jordan presents our player of the game, LeBron James.